Alright, next up, we are going to try to build. We're not going to try to build, we're going to fucking build it. We're going to try to build the to-do list, okay? So the to-do list is going to be a little bit similar to what we have on greetings. The only difference is that we are not going to have like the hiding and showing. It's going to be just right out there because it's a to-do list. So let's make a new file, to-do.js. And let's add this file over here, to-do.js. Lovely. Now under greetings, let's make a form and let's make this class. I think I should have been better with classes here in JS form rather than just JS form, something like JS form greeting. In this case, to-do form. Okay, that's better. And then I'm gonna do input type. This will be text, and the placeholder will be write a to-do. This keyword is shit. Never ever bite. All right, and now we're gonna make a list, and here the list is gonna be class JS to-do list, and this will be empty. Great. All right, let's just copy this and try to find it here. Const form equals document query selector JS to do form, and then here list. No, let's get the input as well. The input is simple. We say form document, query selector input, but these names are going to collide, and this is not good because they are constants, and this is not good. If you want to learn how you can have small modules, you need to look into the zero to hero JS course that we have here in Nomad Academy, because I'm going to show you how you can make and use JavaScript modules to be able to isolate them. Instead of here having to change that, because now we cannot use the same name. To do form, and here to do input. All right, and now also to do list equals document query selector. Query selector, and it's JS. Forgot to-do list. Bravo. All right. As always, function init, and then we call the init function. All right. And what we're gonna do in function init is we're going to, let's just do it. Load to-dos. As always, all right? Like the other one, it's very similar because we have to load something and it comes from local storage, all right? And then now we have zero function, load to-dos. And then again, to-dos equals local storage dot get item. Let's make a constant over here saying get item to-dos. To-dos, local storage. Let's just call this thing to-dos. All right, and I'm gonna get that thing here. To-dos ls, bravo, wonderful. All right, and now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say if to-dos equals no, else, this I will do later. Here, if to-dos equals no, I'm gonna take to-do form. If to-dos equals null, I'm gonna do nothing. Because anyways, the form is always showing. So I actually have to do nothing. What do I have to do? No, I have to do anything, nothing. So this is useless. All right, I have to say if to-dos is not null, I'm gonna do something. That's basically it, okay? Now here, We're gonna do this later because we wanna, if we find to do this on the local storage, we need to add them doing some kind of weird stuff. So what we're gonna do here is just create a to-do. So we're gonna say to-do form at event listener, and like before, submit. And here we are going to say handle submit. Okay, and here we do function handle submit, and this takes an event, of course, because we want to prevent the event, prevent default. Okay, and also we're gonna do the same thing as before, current value equals to do input dot value. Okay, and let's make another function called paint to do, and this takes the text, of course. Okay, and we're gonna call this function paint to do with the current value. All right, let's test this thing. Come here, refresh, write a to do. Nico, enter. Okay, should be working. Let's just console log it. Text to see if it's working. What is the problem? To do input. Oh, it's not form, sorry. It's to do form. It was taking the previous form, the form of the name. That's why. All right. Working. Awesome. Also, what I want to do is when somebody presses enter, I want to create the to do and I want to eliminate this thing. So all I have to do is say to do input dot value equals done. There we go. So it's like submit. Bravo. Okay. Awesome. Now let's create the to do. So what I'm gonna do is come here and paint to do. And basically, what do I wanna do and how is the to do gonna look? The to do is gonna look very, very simple. It's gonna be a LI. It's gonna have an ID of a number like this, one, for example. And is going to have a text like this here. That's basically what it's gonna be, okay? Okay, awesome. So now what I wanna do, and you know what, the ID, it can be later, doesn't matter. Now what I want to do is I want to do paint to do, and I'm going to create first of all the UL, and this is something that you haven't seen before. Usually what we do is that we query selectors. This means we get stuff from the HTML. Now what about if we want to create something? It's very, very simple. All we have to do is we say document create element. And here the element we're going to create is a UL. Okay, this name doesn't matter. This can be potato. Doesn't matter as long as this is a UL. All right. Sorry, not UL, fucking retard, LI. All right. Sweet. Then what we are going to do is that we are going to say LI dot inner text, no, because what I want to do also is I want to put a button to delete. So I'm going to say const delete button equals document create element button. Okay, and then delete button inner, no, it's a button, right? So it has a value equals this emoji. Okay, then I'm gonna say const span, whatever, document create element span. All right, and now I say span dot inner text is the text from the submit function, the value, the text. All right, and now I have to say li dot, and I need to do something that is called append child. What it does is that it puts something inside of the father. So here I'm gonna do li append child. First, I wanna append the span, and then I wanna append the delete button. All right. And last but not least, now that I created an empty li, then I created a button and I created a span, and then I put the span inside of the li and I put the button inside of the li. So now all I have to do is say to do list append child and just this li that I just created. Finish. Let's see if it works. All right, I'm gonna write a to-do, and when I press enter, I should create a li, create the delete button, create the span, append the span and the delete button into the li, and then lastly, append the li to the UL. Go. There we go. Awesome. I'm gonna change this for inner value, inner text. I made a mistake. Again, hello. Nice. Inner HTML then. Fuck, it's just an emoji, bro. All right, working. Don't know why the emoji doesn't work. This is weird. Maybe charge it here. Let's try again. There we go. It was this bullshit here, meta charge it. Okay, so it's working, people. We are able to create something. Look at this. We create an element. We actually create it and we actually put it where we want it to be, inside of the UL that it's supposed to be empty, but it's not empty. Look at that, it's not empty anymore. Now I'm gonna switch the order so I can have the button first and then the text. Awesome. All right, people, see you on the next one. Bye-bye.